This is another sign of the times, an analysis and a commentary. Hurricane Irma. Authorities sent an aircraft carrier and other Navy ships to help with search and rescue operations in Florida as a flyover of the hurricane battered Keys yielded what the governor said were scenes of devastation. "I just hope everyone survived," Governor Rick Scott said. He said boats were cast ashore, water, sewers, and electricity were knocked out. "And I don't think I saw one trailer park where almost everything wasn't overturned." Crews struggled to clear the one highway connecting the string of islands to the mainland. Statewide, an estimated 13 million people, or two-thirds of Florida's population, remained without power. That's more than the population of New York and Los Angeles combined. Officials warned it could take weeks for electricity to be restored to everyone. The scale of the damage inflicted by Irma began to come into focus as the hurricane weakened to a tropical storm and finally pushed its way out of Florida, but not before dealing a parting shot by causing severe flooding around Jacksonville and the state's northeastern corner. During its rainy, windy run up the more than 400-mile length of Florida, Irma swamped homes, uprooted trees, flooded streets, snapped miles of power lines, and toppled construction cranes. In the Jacksonville area, close to the Georgia line, storm surge brought some of the worst flooding ever seen there, with at least 46 people pulled from swamped homes. Florida has emerged from Hurricane Irma as a landscape of blacked-out cities, shuttered gas stations, shattered trees, and flooded streets. Major streets remained underwater in cities from Miami to Jacksonville, with even more roads snarled by debris. They also say, "You pay a price for paradise." In the Florida Keys, it's hurricanes. The stretch of highway that leads to the continental United States' southernmost point was riddled with jet skis, seaweed, and the occasional refrigerator. In a few places, the ferocious force of water from Hurricane Irma's onslaught washed out chunks of the two-lane highway. The National Guard was now at work clearing the trees that blocked the road. The landscape is a seemingly random mix of the lost and the saved, homes and businesses unscathed in the wake of a storm that appeared to pick and choose its targets, taking a roof here and a yacht there, leaving roads littered with random debris. All of the power and much of the water system are out. The Department of Defense, which is helping with the relief effort, said because of damage to the island and its water system, it may be necessary to evacuate the 10,000 people who did not leave before the storm. From Key Largo to Key West, coastal homes were saturated by a vicious storm surge that rose chest high, wrecking homes and vehicles, leaving behind a stench of sewage and the sea. The Category 4 storm, with sustained winds of 130 miles per hour, took most mobile homes, toppling gas station pumps and splitting trees in two. In Cudjoe Key, few people were on the streets because the authorities have not permitted even residents to return to their homes to assess the damage. The only people around were those who rode out the storm at local shelters and some who were brave or foolish enough to confront Irma themselves. Officials with Monroe County, which covers the entire Keys, said the area continues to be closed for residents and visitors. Roads remain unsafe from debris, which includes boats, downed trees, downed power lines, sand, and washed out roadway. All three of the Keys hospitals remain closed, schools remain closed, and there is still a dawn to dusk curfew until further notice, officials said. They also say Hurricane Harvey is expected to be one of the costliest storms in U.S. history, after dumping torrents of rain on the greater Houston metropolitan area of more than 6.7 million people. More than 300,000 homes in Texas were damaged or destroyed by the floods. Even more is potentially at stake in Irma, which hit in large sections of Florida, a state with more than 20 million people. Data provider CoreLogic Incorporated estimated that 12 million properties in Florida could be damaged by winds or the storm surge. The energy industry has already taken a significant hit. U.S. crude prices fell after Harvey hit the eastern coast of Texas and forced the shutdown of more than 20% of U.S. refining capacity. Crude prices began recovering as refiners near the Gulf Coast planned restarts, easing demand concerns. Gasoline prices remain elevated, reflecting refinery outages and the vulnerability of the U.S. gasoline distribution system to storms that hit the southeast. This, too, is another sign of the end of times as we know them. Transition days, which is a time of extraordinary changes, events, and happenings. This is also a sign of overpopulation and having too many people in vulnerable areas where hurricanes might hit. It's also about what kind of world are we leaving to the future generations? And that should be a very important question to ask. Again, this is the warning. Ezekiel chapter 13, verse 10. Because they have seduced my people, saying peace, and there was no peace, and one built up a wall, and yes, others made it with untempered mortar or cement. Say unto them which make it with untempered mortar or cement, but it shall fall, there shall be an overflowing shower, and ye, O great hailstones, shall fall, and a stormy wind shall rend it or break it. Yes, when the wall is fallen, shall it not be said unto you, where is the cement wherewith you have cemented it? Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, I will even rend it or break it with a stormy wind in my fury, and there shall be an overflowing shower in mine anger, and great hailstones in my fury to consume it. So I will break down the wall that you have daubed or made with untempered mortar, and bring it down to the ground, so that the foundation thereof shall be discovered, and it shall fall, and you shall be consumed in the midst thereof, and you shall know that I am the Lord. Thus will I accomplish my wrath upon the wall, and upon them that have cemented it with untempered mortar, and will say unto you, the wall is no more, neither they that daubed it or cemented it. To wit, the prophets of the world, which prophesize concerning Jerusalem or America, which see visions of peace for her, and there is no peace, saith the Lord God. Likewise, thou son of man, set thy face against the daughters of thy people, which prophesize out of their own heart, and prophesize thou against them, and say, thus says the Lord God, woe to the women that sew pillows to all armholes, and make kerchiefs upon the head of every stature to hunt souls. Will you hunt the souls of my people, and will you save the souls alive that come unto you? And will you pollute me among my people for handfuls of barley and for pieces of bread, to slay the souls that should not die, and to save the souls alive that should not live, by your lying to my people that hear your lies? Wherefore, thus says the Lord God, behold, I am against your pillows, wherewith you there hunt the souls to make them fly, and I will tear them from your arms and will let the souls go, even the souls that you hunt to make them fly. Your kerchiefs also will I tear and deliver my people out of your hand, and they shall be no more in your hand to be hunted, and you shall know that I am the Lord, because with lies you have made the heart of the righteous sad, whom I have not made sad, and strengthened the hands of the wicked, but he should not return from his wicked way by promising him life. Therefore you shall see no more vanity, nor divine divinations, for I will deliver my people out of your hand, and you shall know that I am the Lord God Almighty. Yes, it's time for prophecy to be fulfilled. And all these are more signs.